influence at the palace.
The one who foiled the plot against our city. The sun honors me with our meeting. Renora, I'm the mournful Naman. My apologies that we meet like this.
Like this?
In grief. You hold yours close, like a talisman. Wait, forgive me. You didn't come for reparations? Someone you lost to the Sun Ring?
No. I know about the Red Raids, but the Karja owe me nothing.
I see. Well, I could use the help of a strong-willed outlander. Then I would owe you very much indeed. These people seek to honor their loved, their lost, with their own voices, not mouthing Karja rituals to Karja stone. But there are obstacles. While Meridian holds its breath for any disturbance, these robes only tie my hands.
What kind of obstacles?
The first pilgrim is an Asaram who seeks to visit the Shrine of Kings on the road to the city. He waits there now, forbidden to enter by an old sun priest who suffer no heathen. This Utaru lost her companion on the edge of the jewel, at a pool where snap moths gather. The shrine was built there to ward off the machines, and its effectiveness leaves much to be desired. And the Manuk would paint a mark on the sun's climb, a call to the machine spirits, I understand. They need no beckoning. Glinthawks perch there, drawn to the spire's shining.
So clear the machines out of two shrines and move a priest out of the other.
All I can ask for is your charity and that their stories are heard.
Naman, rituals and prayers can't bring back those who are lost.
No, but it can help those who grieve to find themselves. It can lend them strength and hope, like a new sunrise.
I didn't think your priesthood would ask outsiders for help.
If only the sun was set on our pride. Until this is done, I am no sun priest. To wear a red robe was an aspiration. I aspired. Now our hoods make us blind. We whisper reconciliation, but forget how the old king's priests sang the words and blessed the killing.
The killing? You mean the Red Raids?
Yes. And the sacrifices that came after.
Why did the priests go along with all that bloodshed?
Sometimes we Karja are more concerned with what is tradition than what is right.
Huh. Maybe the Karja and Nora aren't so different. You're disappointed with the Sun Priests, but you still wanted to be one?
I spent my whole life looking up to the temple. My brother's voice echoing in its arches. Even he couldn't turn me away, and how he tried, in the end. He said, when we were loved, our robes were dyed in cinnabar. Now they are stained in blood.
How so?
Our robes are handed down to us. Most of the old priests fled rather than be seen in the glare of a new sun. And so we are left to wear their sins. For me, at least, they hang heavy.
Where is your brother now?
He waits for me on the trail of the sun, I hope. He spoke out against the sacrifices. For a priest to question the Sun King's will, his punishment was worst of all.
You lost someone you loved, too. I'm sorry.
No, not lost. When I took on these robes, I found his memory.
I'll do what I can to help those in mourning.
To honor their memories is to honor us all.
Some Asaram girl applied to the city guard the other day.
That Naman told me about.
You won't get in there. That dried-up old prune in a robe sees to that.
I can be persuasive. But what does an Osirom want with a Karja shrine, anyway?
It reminds me of someone. Gone 2 years now. But what does a girl like you know of loss?
Try me.
I had a lover. Worked on monuments to their bastard king. Then he gave them a show in their sun ring for good measure. The Karja gave me back his broken bones, but what use are they? They won't build again. They won't make me smile.
And seeing a statue of the Mad Sun King will?
I need to see his work again. The marks his hands carved. The set of the metals they hammered. That's the soul of him. But that shriveled up old priest won't let me near it.
I'll see what I can do.
Turn away, child. The abiding Jahaman wishes to be alone in his retreat.
If you want to be alone, go someplace else. Others want to pray here.
Defile it, you mean? Yet another debasement of what was once pure. Truly, our tribe has lost the light. Our king is false, our temple is corrupt, and our soldiers weak. The sun hastens across the sky for shame.
So the Karja have become impure? What does that even mean?
Is Meridian not meant for those who built it, who made it great? It was pure before Outlander squatters took it over.
You mean Meridian was pure when the Outsiders were in cages or dying in your arena?
The sun is pure, child. It is not our place to question its divine will, only to act upon it.
I thought Avad taking the throne was the sun's will.
The boy dishonored his father, dishonored us all. To kill a Sun King. What shadow, what twilight time he brought upon us.
And how many more would the Mad Sun King have killed if Avad hadn't stopped him?
The Sun called for blood. There was no choice but to obey.
You called the temple corrupt, but aren't you one of its priests?
They call themselves Sun Priests, but they have no authority. Youths and sycophants all. Yet those who gave their whole lives to the sun's service are shamed and ignored.
So that's what this is. A tantrum? A cry for attention?
You know nothing of our rights, and yet you dare to insult me.
Why do you think your army is weak? Because you're not at war with everyone?
A Karja throne relying on forged dirt mercenaries? Preposterous! The so-called liberation was nothing but a purge. Our most blessed warriors, chased out of the city, exiled to Sunfall and the Forbidden West. Our tribe is torn. The ones who walked in light now go by shadow.
And yet everyone but you seems happy they're gone. I'm done arguing with you. Stay or go, but I won't allow you to keep others away.
I am here by the will of the sun.
You don't believe in the throne, the priesthood, the army, or the city, so I guess you have no authority here.
I have the authority of the sun!
Then call it for help. No one else will listen.
There'll be a reckoning.
You'll back away from it.
Look, I've got a pair of sturdy Osirom hands. I know how to put them to use. They'll always be work for me. Aaron ain't quite his sister. But he's led us well. He'll sort himself out much.
He gave them the best work he'd ever do. And look at it now.
They defaced it because they hated what it stood for.
They defaced a thing slaves like him lived and died for. Slaves they've already forgotten. Short-sighted bastards, the lot. If they thought their son set off this bridge, they'd jump after it. I thank you for honoring my wish.
I hope you can find peace.
I wouldn't know what to do with it. Any more than the Karja do.
I'm sure about the sun and the thirst.
Quick way down. This must be the sun's climb, where the Banuk wants to paint his mark.
City. You are a better hunter than I. I'll paint the mark while the spirits of the Glintocks linger.
There'll be more where they came from.
Yes. There will always be more machines. Their spirits find new bodies, but we only last as long as memory. That's why I must leave this story. A monument to our vanished shamans. To the wisdom the Karja bled from us. The machine oil in the paint will preserve it. Preserve their memory against all that was cut away. You have my thanks, Hunter.
Going down fast.
When we fled from our cages during the liberation, I tore through this clearing, thinking my friend was behind me. I kept running, but here she remains. Thank you for making it safe for me to return.
I don't want to rush you, but it won't stay safe for long.
I understand. I've done this before in waking dreams. In the pool, I'll find the bracelet of seeds she dropped when she fell. The seeds will be split, escaped, grown wild. She's passing from my memory into the jungles. I'll tell her it was I who died here and became a stranger in our own land, and she who still lives in every time of planting, of rains, harvests, and... Oh.
What is it?
There. Her bracelet. And... I thought she was behind me. But there's only my reflection.
Do you need to be alone?
For the first time, I am.
Something today?
We're letting the Oseron.
Pleasure to see you're one of us now, both of you.
So you've come back to the temple.
I was invited back. The priests wanted to hear what I had to say about reconciliation with the other tribes. They're listening. At least they've begun to listen. There's a distance between ears and heads.
Because of what we did?
What you did.
It was for the mourners. I think it helped them.
You set them on the path. You can't know what their journeys hold.
Such is the priest's lot. Perhaps a red robe would suit you.
Not me. Besides, your temple doesn't even take women.
We would be richer if we did. Go in light, my friend. And let the sun cast your way.
Thank you, Naman. Where I'm going, I could probably use all the light I can get.